Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm so excited that you're here. Today's video is going to be a talk through video, and it's going to be about finding your purpose and living as a 20 something and navigating through this generation, because I know that it's super tough. I'm 23 years old right now, and I'm challenging myself to only introduce positive content into my life. So the first thing I want to share that resonated with me is the fact that God created you for a specific purpose. And that specific purpose is not only going to benefit you, but it's also going to benefit and be a blessing to those around you. Sometimes your purpose is going to require that you're in a place that's out of your comfort zone. It's even going to put a strain on you sometime to where you don't even think that you should be doing it. It's going to require more of you than what you want to give sometimes, but you'll notice people around you benefiting and being blessed. If you have any questions about who and why you were created, I would suggest that you ask the one who created you. Ask God. Spend time in his word to get to know what he says about who you are as a person. A lot of times we like to ask our friends and our family members for their advice on what we should be doing, who we are, and you know, where we should be going and what the next steps is that we should be taking. And I'm guilty of that. I do it like all the freaking time. And it's good sometimes if you need that time just to really bounce ideas off of somebody and get someone's advice. However, your friends and family can't give you the kind of perspective that you need. They can't look at your life in totality and give you the best response, okay? It's kind of gonna be just something that's good. They're only gonna give you advice that's good. It's just gonna be satisfactory. And good is a sin when greater is available. When you find out who you are and what you're called to be, you're gonna feel a sense of peace. Well, I mean, I imagine, so I'm pretty sure you're gonna feel a sense of peace, and that's gonna impact everything that you do. It's gonna impact where you go, who and what you give your time to, okay? It's gonna change the way that you respond and react to the environment and the situations that you're put. When I realized this about peace and how it affects us, really challenged me to make sure that my peace going forward is something that I would always hold in the highest regard, and I would always be protective. Being protective of your heart and peace is very difficult if you are using your friends and your relationships to validate who you are and what your purpose is and what your value is. So basically, if you are using those people for a validation on you and what you believe about yourself, you're always gonna be on an emotional roller coaster, right? Because sometimes they may be super happy about what you're doing. They may be super supportive. And then other times they may not even give you that same level of validation or no validation at all. So then during those times, you're gonna have a lower level of self-worth, and you're not going to feel as whole and complete, right? It's going to be wavering. It's not going to be anything constant and consistent. It's only his word that's constant. You know what he expects of you, okay? You're not on an up and down roller coaster on who you are. And if validation is something that you struggle with by seeking it from other people, sometimes you don't even realize that you're doing it, right? Like if you notice yourself only listening to a certain type of music when you're around certain people, just so they'll like you or feel like they can bond with you, if you only talk a certain way around certain people, dress a certain way around certain people, like all that stuff is subconscious ways of you seeking validation from people. I also find that people, they need validation from social media. Like they need validation in their likes on Instagram and how many people view their story. Like it's crazy. And I really challenge everybody to take some time and disconnect from those things. Disconnect from spending time in social comparison and comparing yourself to people that you really don't even like, that you don't even talk to like that, okay? Delete the app for 2 weeks out of every month. Delete Facebook for 2 weeks. I really like on Instagram now, in your settings, I think it's a new feature to where you can view your activity for the week. It'll tell you how many hours, how many minutes of every day that you spend on that app. And you can even set a limit for yourself. You can say, I only want to spend 45 minutes, and then it will alert you when that time is up, and it's just you that has to be disciplined enough to turn off the app and not log on until the next day. Lastly, stop thinking things in your life are a waste of time. I struggle with this. I always used to think, oh my gosh, if I talk to this guy and we don't end up getting in a relationship or we don't end up getting married, then it was just a complete waste of time. Or if I apply for this job and I don't get this job, you know, I interviewed and it was a complete waste of time. And that's so not true, because every situation that you get involved in is meant to give you data. And not just data on the other person, not just data on the situation, but data on yourself. Like, I bet you didn't know how crazy you was until you ended up inside his bushes outside. I bet you didn't know how persistent and how determined you were until you had to go on multiple job interviews to get the job that, not the one that you wanted, but the one that God had for you. Okay, so every situation is meant to teach you something. Like me, I learned this year trying to go to AGP that planning a trip with black people, specifically my Lion sisters, is an extreme sport, okay? It's not for the faint at heart. And I've heard over and over again that God will repeat the same lesson in your life until you learn it. And I'm tired of learning the same lessons, y'all. I don't know about you, but I'm tired. I feel like it is worth it to do the self-introspection, do the self-work, to learn the lessons that you're supposed to learn so you don't have to learn it anymore going forward. And you can be mentally and emotionally and physically stronger from it, okay? Hindsight is 20/20. You can always look back and be like, okay, God, I see what you was doing here. Or man, I should have did this. Or man, I should have did that. But wouldn't it be better if now, with each situation and new person that you meet going forward, you say, God, show me what it is that I need to see now so I don't end up in something that I shouldn't be in. God, what is it that you want me to learn from this going forward? Guide my steps so therefore you don't have to end up in a situation of shoulda, woulda, coulda, but God guided me through. You're gonna have to go through trials and tribulations inevitably in life, and these things are only gonna take you on the path to find your purpose. I challenge each of you to find what gives you peace, not happiness. Because I hear so many people say, oh, that's my goal in life, I just want to be happy. But do you guys not know that happiness is an emotion? It's fleeting. One minute you can be happy and the next minute you're sad, the next minute you're aggravated, okay? But peace is something that can stand still. It can stand on its own. You can abide in peace and still be happy. You can abide in peace and still be sad. Why? Because you're at peace knowing that you've helped somebody, that where you are in life matters. Thank you guys so much for watching. This video was so important for me to make, y'all, because these past 2 years for me have been really crazy, really challenging, the hardest years I've ever been through in my life, like bringing me to my lowest point. So I am really just trying to, like I said at the beginning, get on an evil level playing field with myself. And so if I can help other people do that while I'm trying to do it myself, then, you know, then hey, why not? Like, it's cool. I should be doing it. I should, to bring myself some peace. Like, yes, I'm helping somebody. Peace. Okay. Stay tuned for my next video. Subscribe and give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. And let me know in the comments if I should do more talk through videos. I appreciate you guys, really, truly. Have a good day, guys. Bye.